was all around Veterans Park Saturday morning.
I only have a staff of 5, and we cover the entire state of Connecticut. So we obviously don't do this ourselves. It's really the work of so many people.
Over 1,000 supporters, including breast cancer survivors and sponsors of breast cancer awareness, walked in red around Seaview Avenue for the 2nd annual Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure in Fairfield County.
Thank you so much to Komen and to New Balance for letting me be your survivor today.
I lost my mother to cancer when I was 9 months old. She was 31, and I lost my stepmother to breast cancer. She was 63. And I've watched too many women suffer, battle this disease, lose the battle.
It's the first time Komen Connecticut has hosted the event in Norwalk. Organizers hope to raise about $300,000 for research and awareness programs. They say without the support of Norwalk's leaders, sponsors, and 150 dedicated volunteers, the event would not have been possible.
We are very, very encouraged that it is in Norwalk for the first time, and we just wanted to be part of it.
The city of Norwalk has been incredible in supporting both the race and the cause that we are working toward. So far it's been a great relationship, and we look forward to coming back here again next year.
Statewide, over 3,000 Connecticut women will be diagnosed with breast cancer this year. Studies show Connecticut has the 2nd highest incidence of breast cancer in the nation, and several Fairfield County towns are among those with the highest rates of breast cancer incidence, mortality, and late-stage diagnosis.
We fund programs to provide free services to women that don't have insurance, so there's no reason why women shouldn't get screened in the state of Connecticut.
75% of the funds raised remain in Connecticut and go directly to investments in local breast cancer education, screenings, and treatment programs across the state. The remaining 25% is invested in research to help find causes and cures for breast cancer. In Norwalk, I'm Priscilla Lombardi for It's Relevant News.